Welcome to a dissection of the thigh. Dr. Sanjoy Sanyal, Professor Department Chair. This is the left side of the cadaver, and this is the deep fascia of the thigh, which has been removed. This lateral portion, this thick portion that you see here, this is the iliotibial tract, and this is the other cut portion of the fascia. This deep fascia of the thigh is called the fascia lata. That has been completely removed here. Let's take a quick look at the muscles of the anterior compartment. So this is the anterior compartment of the thigh. The first muscle which comes to our view is this long strap-like muscle here. This is the sartorius, the Tailor's muscle. It starts origin from the anterior superior iliac spine and goes obliquely down all the way and gets inserted into the pes and serenus on the medial side of the tibia. So this is the sartorius. The next muscle that we see when I reflect the sartorius is this one here. This is the rectus femoris. This has got two origins, a straight head and a reflected head. The straight head takes origin from the anterior inferior iliac spine, and the reflected head from just above the acetabular margin. And this is a powerful kicking muscle. And if there's a loss of function of this muscle, it is equivalent to loss of 78% function of the quadriceps. So this is the most superficial muscle of the quadriceps femoris. When I lift up the rectus femoris, I see a muscle under that. And this muscle that you see here, this is the vastus intermedius, which takes origin from the anterior surface of the femur. Immediately lateral to that is the largest muscle of the quadriceps, and you can see it here. This is the vastus lateralis. The vastus lateralis, as I said, is the largest muscle, and we have already mentioned that it is covered on the lateral aspect by the iliotibial tract. Posteriorly, the vastus lateralis is covered by the lateral intermuscular septum. And on the medial side, we see this muscle here. This is the vastus medialis. Both these vasti, vastae medialis and vastus lateralis, take origin from behind the femur, from the linea aspera, and they come forward. So we have put all the four muscles of the quadriceps in place, namely the rectus femoris, vastus intermedius, vastus lateralis, and vastus medialis. And all these four muscles, they form a very strong tendon here, just above the patella. And this tendon that you see here, this is the quadriceps tendon. Now the quadriceps tendon gets inserted onto the base of the patella. However, each of these muscles also have independent insertions onto the patella. Then there is a thin aporiotic expansion which goes above the patella, and then it continues down as this strong ligament here that we see, called the ligamentum patellae, or the patellar ligament, which finally gets inserted onto this bony projection on the tibia, which is called the tibial tuberosity. So therefore, the quadriceps final insertion of all the quadriceps is on the tibial tuberosity, with the patella inserted in between, juxtaposed between the quadriceps tendon above and the patellar ligament below. The purpose of the patella is to change the direction of pull and increase the mechanical advantage of the quadriceps muscle. And this is where we tap on the ligamentum patellae to elicit what is known as the knee jerk reflex, or the quadriceps jerk. So these are the muscles, and they're all supplied by the femoral nerve, which I'm going to show you later. So these are the muscles of the anterior compartment. There are a few other muscles which I'm going to show you when I come to the next dissection. Thank you very much for watching, ladies and gentlemen. Have a nice day. Dr. Sanjoy Sanyal signing out.
Like this video and click the subscribe button.